I mean, we build what I call the ecosystem. I mean, the right organizations and the right people with the necessary skills to face new threats, to analyze them, to know how to prevent them, to develop answers, etc. We are one of the very few countries in the world which have a cyber protection system at the government level. I mean, everyone has it in his own company or something like this, but at the government level, there are less than fingers on my hand. We do have it. Well, you cannot really simply take the system we developed here in Israel and copy it to some other countries. I just had a meeting with Rudy Giuliano, and we talked about what lessons can be learned from Israel to the USA. You cannot really copy it because it's different of size, different of culture, different of local constraints and things like this. Still, some principles are more or less the same. The same system at the government level, at the national level that we have in Israel, was adopted also by the UK, which is a different culture, different size, 10 times bigger than Israel. Still, they adopted more or less the same system as Singapore, for example, which is a very smaller even than Israel, and it shows you that the principles can be copied. The organizations, it's a different story because of many times even difference in culture. We work with Italy. As a matter of fact, I just got this morning knighthood from the Italian government, and I thank you very much. But part of the reason for it is that we formed a joint lab with Italy, and many things that many lessons learned here, we can really apply also to Italy, which is much bigger than Israel. Now, Bitcoin is based on certain technology of encryption and data sharing, which we call blockchain. Now, until 2 years ago, something like this, people considered Bitcoin to be something used by the bad guys, by criminals, etc. But then two things changed. One is, you know, Bitcoin is a kind of currency, a kind of coin that is not backed by anyone. I mean, if you use dollars or Israeli shekels or the Italian currency, there is the government behind it. If worse come to worse, you can come with the notes and give it and get some gold or God knows what in return. Bitcoin, no government guarantees, no organization guarantees, no one guarantees it. So this is a big question, how without any guarantee something can have a value that is trusted by so many people. And even the president of the Fed Bank, the Federal Bank of America, 2 years ago, she said, we may copy the technology behind Bitcoin, this is blockchain, we may copy it perhaps to have our own currency. The dollar will not be supported by the gold in Port Knox, but by this technology. This is one reason. Another one, which changed the situation, is that the technology by itself is very open. I mean, everyone can know every minute where is every Bitcoin, every coin. Still, without knowing the persons that, so on one way it's very open, on the other hand, it's fully private. No one can know how many Bitcoins me, myself, Isaac Ben Israel has. But as an address in the system, if I tell you my address, everyone know that this address has this many Bitcoins. So this is, it seems like contradiction. On one hand, very open, everyone knows everything about everyone. On the other hand, it's fully private. And then people started to think about the roots of this technology and say, maybe we may apply it to solve the tensions that we have today between privacy and security intentions that we have with the internet. But it's only the start. We are just doing the first steps in real research, and it's too early to say if it will prove to be successful. Even today, you know, certain countries, you go to the United States, the passport is not enough. You have to give your fingertip, prints, to look at the camera and things like this, which is also a different way from passport. You can change it easily with blockchain technology. I think it is possible even today.
So it will be the secure world we are looking for, if not with this escalation of cyber attacks, we should go down from internet altogether.
Yeah, we may reach a point in which we will have to change the internet. People hate it because it means a lot of investment. I mean, internet today should, every one of us has some investment in the internet. But we may have, at the end of the day, have no other choice because the situation today in which people can attack you through the net and you don't know who is the origin, you cannot attribute the attack to some very definite person, is unbearable. I mean, people do crimes, people do other things through the internet, and no one is going to jail. No one is caught.